All right, Alan, commentary on the situation.
Very fast moving water. The bridge just snapped a couple days ago, and now we got to paddle across this.
Yeah, river. You can scoot back. Someone scoot back a little bit.
It is. It's very shaky.
A little sketchy. A little sketchy here.
Originally, Cleveland High School had approached haponics in a much simpler prospect, but after evaluating the caliber of not only the teacher, but the students that we were engaged with, linking it to the haponics projects around the planet was a no-brainer. So I kind of flip-flopped it on them and said that it would be better if you guys designed for me, and then we could go together and implement it in some real-world programming to actually satisfy the haponics mission of feeding 20 million people by 2020. So I asked the students to build a 16-foot backpackable dome to feed 16 people a day versus me building them an aquaponics system that would never leave their classroom.
What was the hardest part about your design challenge in this project while you're in EDD for the fall semester?
Mainly the time constraint, and then following that the weather, because the weather's not very good for growing crops, so it's hard to experiment in the fall. And then just the fact that you're in a class that's only an hour and a half long, and you got to split it up amongst days.
Okay. Well, the math wasn't that bad. The design wasn't that bad, but fabrication, actually getting the thing ready to go, that was definitely the most time-consuming, the most difficult thing we did.
Tubbs, how do you feel about us going to Nicaragua? You nervous?
Yeah, a little.
You scared? Do you know Spanish?
No.
Better learn some Spanish, man.
I don't know.
So you think this group will be pretty progressive together in the jungle all together?
We'll get stuff done. It's going to be awesome. I got close with all these guys.
Coach Williams, are you excited to go?
I can't wait. It's going to be an adventure of a lifetime.
Are you nervous for all of us?
A little bit.
All right,
we're going to have a dome party.
Yes.
These guys laying around the floor, that's half of the group, and a portion of our group has already been booked and getting ready to board on a small Cessna plane further up the coast, from which we will then take a bone-jarring bus ride, I understand.
Managua, Nicaragua, donde yo me enamoré. Tenía mi burrita, mi vaquita y mi güey. Todito lo tenía, mi cariño también. Y por supuesto, mi mujer también. Managua, Nicaragua, donde yo me enamoré. Tenía mi burrita, mi vaquita y mi güey. Todito lo tenía, mi cariño también. Y por supuesto mi mujer también. Hoy he conocido otros lares, tierras muy lindas, muy bellas. He tenido muy lindos placeres, pero nada como Managua. Managua, Nicaragua, donde yo me enamoré. Tenía mi burrita, mi vaquita y mi güey. Todito lo tenía, mi cariño también. Y por supuesto mi mujer también.
So they're
coming from all over the village. They're coming from probably as far as 10, 15 miles away as their friends or word gets to them that we're in town. They're just coming to see us. They're coming from all of these walking trails that you can see that lead absolutely into the middle of nowhere. And they're, some of them are sleeping in the woods, some of them sleeping in houses, some of them sleeping with families, some of them sleeping on their own. They go as deep as you can imagine.
My name is Philip Daniel. I'm the owner of Worth Construction. I really like the idea of helping people out. The people in Kisalaya really need the help of food. And to build the dome and help them grow their own food is a tremendous, tremendous help to them. And I really enjoyed getting involved in that.
The beauty of the system is it's actually now sitting in Nicaragua and Kisalaya. After the students then took it into the country and fjorded rivers and rode crazy buses and just had a general adventure, which is the regular Hatponics job description. The biggest success was watching these young men from Cleveland, Tennessee, go and have their eyes just open to what the needs of the world really are and how it really applied to what they studied as engineering students, but more importantly, what the role of an engineer in the world can be. We've got food in Nicaragua being produced by systems engineered at Cleveland High School in Tennessee. So I will never discount public education, and this shines a lot of light on what is really possible when you put the young minds of our nation to work on a project that they care about.
And roll.